I've got an unpopular opinion. I think Neil deGrasse Tyson is boring unless he's in a very structured format. For example, his old show Cosmos was amazing. It was fantastic. I watched it many times until it got pulled off Netflix. But you know what's not fantastic? His podcast. It's boring. And do you know why? Because it's not very scripted. And you know what's even more boring? The two times that I can remember off the top of my head that he went on the Joe Rogan Experience, I was so excited. Neil deGrasse Tyson with Joe, things didn't get interesting. No, I was wrong. They weren't interesting. Not only was Neil boring, but he was also kind of arrogant. And I was very disappointed. The reason why I'm bringing this up is because Neil deGrasse Tyson played the race card recently. And the way he played it has me asking myself, is Neil deGrasse Tyson an anti-racist, aka a racist? Through Eric Weinstein, or Weinstein, I'm not sure how to pronounce it, on Twitter, I came across this guy called Brian Keating, Dr. Brian Keating, who also has a YouTube channel with 30,000 subscribers. A little bit more than me, so subscribe and maybe I'll catch up one day. Now this guy, Brian, had an interview with Neil deGrasse Tyson, and it's in that interview that Neil pulled the race card. Now Brian tweeted this, "I debated whether or not to release this clip. I know I don't come off so great, and that's okay. In the end, I thought my dialogue with Neil Tyson was worth a listen by everyone navigating difficult conversations." Well, I'm not going to show you the whole thing because honestly, I'm not very interested in it. And I don't think you will either, though I will put the link in the description. I will show you the part where he plays the race card, which is at the beginning, and then how arrogant he acts. So, lo and behold, here's Neil deGrasse Tyson's race card.
I'm gonna call you out on something. You ready? Are you seated?
I'm ready. I got my, hold on, let me get my scotch ready. Fortify. Okay, go for it.
I'm gonna pull the race card on you. Are you ready?
This has never happened before on the Into the Impossible podcast. Go for it.
There is a tendency for a white person upon seeing a highly talented black person to say, "Oh, it's a gift. It's just genetic. It's just," rather than say, "Boy, you must have worked really hard to achieve that." And that disconnect manifested in your very question to me. Because you, it was not even in you to imagine that I wasn't good at communicating at some early point in my life. I say, "Well, how can I get better at this? Let me think about this." Here's an example of how it got manifested. Okay, when I got my first invitation to appear on The Daily Show with Jon Stewart, I said, "Oh my gosh, that's dangerous. This guy's all in your face. Let me watch a few of these shows." So I watched it, and I timed how many seconds he gives his guests to speak before he interrupts comedically. And if you're a politician, you've got your stump speech and you got to get it out, and he interrupts it, oh my gosh, you're flustered and you're deer in the freaking headlights. So I said, that is not going to happen to me. So I timed this. So I said, I'm going to parcel my information that I'm going to share in that show in 6 to 9 second increments, so that when he does jump in, the thought has been completed. Then we can both laugh, and then I go on to the next thought, and there's no deer in the headlights. Not only that, I monitored how far back he reaches for a current event.
I know some of you out there are thinking, "Hey, that wasn't that bad. It is a stereotype to call smart black people articulate." Sure, maybe, but that's not what happened here. Neil deGrasse Tyson is not just some articulate black guy. Neil deGrasse Tyson is one of the most articulate people in the world. Black, white, or Asian. Neil deGrasse Tyson is known for how well he can communicate, articulate. I want to learn from him. In fact, I want to show you one of my favorite clips of Neil deGrasse Tyson, where he's asked an impromptu question and his answer is magnificent. And it shows you how articulate this guy really is. Enjoy.
Is the most astounding fact you can share with us about the universe?
The most astounding fact.
The most astounding fact
is the knowledge that the atoms
that comprise life on Earth, the atoms that make up the human body, are traceable to the crucibles that cooked light elements into heavy elements in their core under extreme temperatures and pressures. These stars, the high mass ones among them, went unstable in their later years. They collapsed and then exploded, scattering their enriched guts across the galaxy. Guts made of carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, and all the fundamental ingredients of life itself. These ingredients become part of gas clouds that condense, collapse, form the next generation of solar systems, stars with orbiting planets. And those planets now have the ingredients for life itself. So that when I look up at the night sky, and I know that, yes, we are part of this universe, we are in this universe, but perhaps more important than both of those facts is that the universe is in us. When I reflect on that fact, I look up. Many people feel small because they're small and the universe is big, but I feel big because my atoms came from those stars. There's a level of connectivity. That's really what you want in life. You want to feel connected. You want to feel relevant. You want to feel like you're a participant in the goings-on of activities and events around you. That's precisely what we are, just by being alive.
How amazing was that? That is an incredibly talented, gifted, hardworking, articulate man. All of the above. Just like the NBA players who worked their asses off to get to the NBA, they are also gifted. And you're just like that. You worked your ass off, but you're gifted, and it's okay to acknowledge it. Now, what worries me about Neil deGrasse Tyson is that he's seeing everything through the lens of race. He's practicing critical race theory. When somebody asks an incredibly gifted person like Neil deGrasse Tyson about his gift of articulation, and immediately he goes into, what, because I'm black? That's either critical race theory has infected his brain or he has some type of insecurity. I don't think he would all of a sudden develop an insecurity about his communication skills or his blackness. So I'm going to say he's got some type of critical race theory going on in his brain. And that worries me. That worries me. Now, do you want to see what it's like for a white person to call a black guy articulate in a racist way? Well, ladies and gentlemen, look no farther than current President Joseph Biden addressing ex-president Barack Obama. Pay attention. This is racist.
But it was old media that got him in trouble. Personal comments he made about another White House hopeful, Senator Barack Obama, recorded by a reporter for the New York Observer.
I mean, you got the first sort of mainstream African American who was articulate and bright and clean and nice-looking guy. I mean, that's a storybook, man. Yeah.
How's that for a racism? The articulate? Woo! But then you add the clean comment on top of that? But hey, that's Joseph Biden, the president we needed to unify America. And that's it for today, folks. Unfortunately, I can't upload this video today because YouTube has given me another strike. Why? Well, because I played a clip of Alex Jones, persona non grata on YouTube. Apparently, if you play a clip of someone who has been banned on YouTube, you violated the community guidelines. Whoopsie! Thanks, tyrants. So please, like, subscribe, comment, share, so more people can see what I'm talking about. My ideas. And so YouTube will stop gagging me. Enough already. 1 year in the channel, 2 strikes for nonsense? Enough. Enough. Like, comment, subscribe, share. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time if my channel still exists.